Hello everybody, welcome to our video tutorials. In this video, we will show you a feature in our easygen-3000XT controllers, called Neutral Interlocking. Why do we want Neutral Interlocking? In case of a ground fault with multiple generators synchronized on an island, we need to make sure that trip command is executed. In order to do that, we only want one neutral contactor of the whole genset system connected to the ground. This is because if a ground fault occurs on one generator, all of the generators are feeding the earth fault current. Now, in this situation, we need to measure the ground current and send a trip command. But this will be only working if only one of the gensets is measuring the ground current. Otherwise, it will be divided and not monitored correctly. So, the general rule is that only one neutral contactor of all running generators are closed. The logic ensures that with changing of generators the neutral link is passed over to another running generator. Let us see how this works on our simulation. This single line diagram is a part of a bigger project, as you can see, with 8 gensets and a ring path design. However, we will look only on the left power flow path, which is interesting to show neutral interlocking feature. In this application I am going to focus on these 3 gensets. Right now. The first 2 are running parallel to the grid. And the third one is stopped. We do not have neutral contactors closed, because we are parallel to the grid. Let's have a look at relevant parameters in toolkit. In this menu, you can enable or disable the neutral interlocking function and assign the closing priority of the neutral contactor. If you enable the neutral interlocking, the digital input 12 will be used as a feedback of the contactor. To control the closing of the neutral contactor, you can assign the Logics Manager 03.39 to a discrete output. Okay, back to simulation. Now, I am going to decouple our 2 generators from the grid. As you can see, the neutral contactor immediately closed and stayed only closed on the highest priority generator. Now, let's start 3rd generator. Notice, they are all in the same segment, so that the neutral contactor will stay closed as before on the first genset. However, if we open the tiebreaker and the 3rd genset will be alone in a different segment, its neutral contactor is closing. For the last test, if we stop the 1st genset, you can see the easygen's exchange information between them and the neutral contactor on the 2nd genset is closed. What is important here? Is that the easygens will do that with make before break logic, to ensure we always have at least one neutral contactor in segment closed. This means, we have our application monitored and safe from ground faults all the time. Also worth noting is that, if a generator is in cooldown and its breaker is open to be safe, it keeps its neutral contactor closed. This is all for today, make sure you check our other video tutorials.